Hello, how's everybody? Have you tried cream of broccoli? No? So that means you have not been at Soup Plantation? Okay, Soup Plantation has it, but unfortunately it's not vegan. It has chicken and beef broth. Yes. Same thing in Sizzlers. They have cream of broccoli, but it has those ingredients, plus cheese, right? So today I'm going to show you how to make a vegan cream of broccoli soup. Okay, ready? Follow your recipe.
Oh, yeah, I don't need.
So here I have cashew nuts. It's a cup. And put them to soak.
Soak
them first. At least 4 hours. Yes. And then the speaker mentioned about nutritional yeast, right? Or nutritional flakes. We're going to need 1/4 cup, and that's going to give it the cheesy flavor. So 1/4 cup. We need 1 clove of garlic, and it's up to you if you want to put more, if you like garlic. I put 1. And then we need 4 parts of a a medium yellow onion. So about that. Then I'm going to add a tablespoon of paprika. Just 1 tablespoon. And then I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of arrowroot. And this is to make it thick. Okay. And then I'm gonna put 1/2 teaspoon sea salt. And this is, you know, to taste, it's up to you. But at least 1/2 will make it. Then I'm gonna add 7 cups of water. And I like to use drinking water for my cooking.
You're not going to get it all in.
So I'm going to add the rest on the pot because I don't want my blender to spill. Just blend. Seal it. Okay, so I'm gonna have my pot.
Yeah, it went on.
And then I'm gonna add the rest of the water. This, we need to stir it once in a while because it was gonna stick to the pot. So stir it once in a while. When it starts to boil, I'm gonna add the broccoli. And this is broccoli florets, but just, you know, cut it a little bit smaller because then it's gonna be big chunks. So once it starts boiling, I'm gonna add the broccoli and then let it boil for about 5 minutes, and then turn it off and let it sit for about 5 minutes. So the broccoli is gonna cook within the steam, right? And this is the way it's going to look. Yes. So this is the way it's gonna look once we finish the process. Go ahead.
That's called fast food.
That's horrible.
What we try to do is give you something simple, something tasty, hopefully, and that maybe you will go home and make, because we don't want it too complicated. So that's, you know, that's what our goal is to do. For this recipe, the cornmeal muffins that you can have with your soup, they are gluten-free because we're going to make the flour out of oatmeal, which is very easy. So before we do that, I want to mix what he talked about, flaxseed having what in it? Do you remember? Yeah, some oil. Omega-3s, right. So we're going to put that in, and this is what will give you an egg-like substance. Instead of using egg, if you want to cut out eggs in your diet, you can do this. We're going to let this sit for a minute. And if it's not quite thick enough, I'll show you what you can do to make it thicken up. But in the meantime, I'm going to show you how you can make from oats, how you can make flour. A little too much. Might go over. Regular oatmeal, and you want it organic because this is, oats are sprayed heavily with glyphosate, which is Roundup when they do the harvesting and so forth. So it's really good to have that as a organic. You can test it by doing this. Yeah, it feels really smooth. Now, this is with a Vitamix, which they work fabulous for so many things. It makes your cooking so much easier. You know, some people that have gotten one. You know, I have found it just invaluable in my kitchen. It's worth putting some money into that instead of upgrading your phone or something, you know, to upgrade your kitchen. A Vitamix. So we're going to dump that into here, and you can... then we'll measure it out. Okay, so we need a cup of the oat flour and a cup of, first I'll put in the, a cup of cornmeal flour. Cornmeal or corn too is good to be organic because corn has been sprayed to get it to harvest. It's much easier if it's the plant has died out, and so they spray that too as well. Okay, so we want a cup of this too. Where's my thing here? And I store this. I blend this up, I throw it in a mason jar and stick it in my freezer, and I can get it out anytime I want, so it'll stay really fresh.
I used comment on how long flaxseed lasts.
3 days.
3 days, that's it.
No, you get the flaxseed and just keep it in your freezer, in your cupboard, it's fine. But to grind it up, I usually will grind it in a small little grinder or something like this. But basically they say the nutritional value is gone within 3 days.
If you freeze it, is that...
I don't know. Where's John Luis? John Luis? Flaxseed, can you store that ground in the freezer and it'll last longer? Yeah.
But
But is it 3 days at the max? That's what I've been...
To ground your flax seed fresh every day if it's possible.
But up to three.
It's not uncommon to go more than 3 days because otherwise the oxidative process, you will lose a lot of nutrition.
Yeah. No, no, no.
But I was wondering if I should not.
Generally, you do not want to eat whole flax seed.
It goes right through you.
But it's a way to store it.
Yes, yes.
You can store it.
So in the freezer, was it any good? It was almost a year. How cold in the freezer?
I think it's good. I think you'll be fine. I mean, I don't know the answer, but I think you'll be fine.
I think it's fine. For
money, you know. And the best way to grind it, if you don't have, like, just get your pepper grinder, stick it into your head, and just do that before you eat it.
Or the little bullet, if you have a little bullet. It's real. Coffee grinder, too. Now, flaxseed is good as an egg replacer if you put it with water. One egg will be 1 tablespoon flaxseed with 3 tablespoons of water. You can just let it sit. Or if you're impatient, you can see right now it's kind of runny and it's got more liquid than not. You can use one of these. And these are great for soup. You can just stick it in your pot of soup and end up blending your soup up into a real creamy soup. Now you'll notice how it drips. It's really thick. We're going to set that right there. Let me show you. It is much thicker than it was just before I did it, and it becomes a real good binding agent. So then we add to that some, instead of sugar, we're going to add maple syrup. You can get maple syrup for really home, you know, real maple syrup from Costco. It's organic. It's really good. But you've got other nutrients in it that you're going to benefit from. That's basically it that I would say.
You can use agave as well.
Agave's kind of low on the list as beneficial. Yeah, that's what I've heard. Now, this is applesauce. We're replacing oil with applesauce. You say, well, I don't have any unsweetened applesauce in my cupboard. So if you have any apples, you just take your apple, throw it in the blender. You don't even have to skin it. You just take the seeds out and blend it up with a little water, and you've got applesauce. So it's real fast if you're looking for something and you don't have it on hand, but you have apples. A lot of times people have apples. Okay, we're going to mix that in. This is the baking soda, baking powder, and salt that we put in. And now while I'm doing this at home, at the same time that I'm putting all these dry ingredients together, I will have a Ziploc bag, and I'll measure out into the Ziploc bag, except the flax, because that has to mix with that. And then I'll put on their cornmeal muffins and stick it in my cupboard, and so all I have to do at another time is just pull it out and put the wet ingredients, and there we got it. So you're always trying to make it easier for yourself. You know, that's real easy to measure one more time. So you get this all mixed in. So it's kind of blended well.
Do you keep it in the refrigerator or in the freezer?
Oh, no. The bag, I just put it in the cupboard. It's fine. Not while it's wet. Okay, then you're going to add. Do we forget anything? No. Add this. And what I've done is I have a silicone pan here. I've just taken and put one little squirt of PAM into each one just because for this it seems to not stick as well, and just wipe it around and it goes into there and then straight into the oven, 20 minutes in the oven. Now we've made some of these for you already. They're not straight from the oven, but if you wait long enough, you could get some out of the oven later. And don't overmix. And somewhere I have a little scooper. Here it is. And then I just, whoops, And then I just scoop it in. And this is... Ooh, no, haven't. That'd be great. I would think. We're going to have too much in there. So if you have problems with gluten, these are gluten-free. If you want to make sure your oats are gluten-free, too, because sometimes they've got some in, because they've been processed with gluten. So I was at Costco yesterday, and I'm standing in line, and in front of me was a lady with all her stuff, and she had some peanut M&Ms in the big Costco bins, you know, that you can get. Oh, they're wonderful tasting. I never keep them in my home because they're very tempting. Anyway, so they're sitting there, and the man behind me comes up, and he goes, and we notice, you know, the peanut M&Ms. And I said, oh, those are dangerous. And he said, I know. And he wanted to put his he had a big, huge bag of carrots, and he wanted to set them down. So we made some room and scooted them. And I said, yeah, they really shouldn't. I can't keep those in my house because I'm tempted. And he goes, yeah, you know what I did? For some reason, he wanted to share. He said, about 6 months ago, I we're trying to make these even so they all come out good. He said, I just quit using processed bagged things like potato chips and crackers and some sweets that were in bags, in boxes, processed. I just cut that out. And he said, I've lost 15 pounds by just doing that. That's all he did. He said, I didn't exercise anything. And I feel so good. And he says, now I'm ready to exercise. By just cutting out that, and, you know, he didn't have to share that with me, but he felt so good about himself that, you know, when you do something that makes you feel good and you feel better, you want to share. You know, and I thought, wow, that's really great. So you have to think of your body as a bank, and that you are either depositing into that bank, you're a health bank, you're either depositing into that bank every day by the things you eat, or you're withdrawing from that bank, and it's not as strong. So just keep thinking, every time you go to look at something, do I want to withdraw from the bank? My health bank, or do I want to, you know, add to it to make it strong? Yeah. Yeah. That is great. Bankrupt. That is great. Yes. And that's what John Luis was saying. You know, there's so many things we're taking away from how our DNA wants to work. Okay, these are going in the oven, and then we're going to serve you some. And the muffins are right here. We'll serve those too.